delegates discussed risk management in considerable detail yesterday, and there seems to be convergence that financial mechanisms, including insurance, can play an important role within a strengthened response to climate change. Many delegates felt that there is a significant need to build technical and institutional capacity to develop and scale up financial mechanisms for risk sharing and risk transfers in developing countries, especially the most vulnerable countries. Parties are also very seriously discussing how to increase adaptation funds, including through the carbon market. As you know, the adaptation fund is filled through a 2% levy on the clean development mechanism and its projects, and discussions are focusing on possibly extending that levy also to joint implementation and emissions trading. And if a decision of that kind were to be taken, either here or in Copenhagen, that would very significantly increase the amount of funding available for adaptation in developing countries. Work on a strengthened climate change response in 2009 is really beginning to intensify in these meeting halls. The need to move to a low-carbon society has been highlighted by many delegations in the meeting. Many countries have cited the emission reduction range of -25% to 40% by 2020 over 1990 levels, and have called on industrialized countries to show leadership in that direction. And what I see emerging is a serious discussion on the need to intensify negotiations as we move into 2009. What is also very useful, I find, is that countries are calling for a coherence on the issues that are being negotiated within the two distinct ad hoc working groups to make sure that that moves forward in a coherent manner. And on the front of the Clean Development Mechanism, there is a discussion emerging on whether a limited number of pilot projects on carbon capture and storage should perhaps be allowed under the Clean Development Mechanism. So all in all, I would say that the contact groups are hard at work. Work is moving forward in all of the different areas. In the ad hoc working group on long-term cooperative action, it's becoming clear that there are a number of areas in which you can see a very clear convergence. But of course, there are always also areas in which there is a very clear difference of opinion. And I think if we can move forward into 2009 by identifying those areas in which there is convergence, identifying the areas in which there is a difference of opinion, and perhaps options can be considered, we will really be making an important advance towards an agreed outcome in Copenhagen.